Hi, and welcome back. So in this section, let's start looking at literals. Literals represent the actual values that you use in the code. These actual values are the values that get computed. For example, if you have a number like 2, this is an actual value. Maybe the statement says 2 plus 2. These are literals. These are actual numbers. Maybe you have something that gives out a statement. Like hi. This is a literal. So literals are the actual values. So we have different types of literals. We have integer literals that refers to the numbers, maybe 2, it can be negative 4, negative 1 million, you know, different kinds of numbers. Integer numbers. Then we also have floating points. Now floating points, these are numbers that have decimals. So 2.11, that's a floating point number. It can also be in the form of an exponential. So 2 exponent or exponential of maybe 4. This is the same as 2 over 1, which essentially is the same as 0.00, then another 0 there, 2. So that's a floating point. It has a decimal and a number that follows the decimal, or the follow of the decimal can even be 0. This is also a floating point number, and it can have an exponential or it can be a fraction. So this part is a fraction. Then we have strings. A string literal contains one or more characters. So, in this one we said hey, hi, that's a string literal. My name is somebody, blah, 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 that's a string literal. Then we have booleans. Booleans only have two possible values. And these two possible values are either true or false. Then we have arrays. An array literal, this one has a group of elements. Different elements can be numbers. In JavaScript, they can be a mixture of numbers and letters. It can even be a statement in there. So that's an array. We are going to look at each and every one of these. Each of them. Then we'll also look at object literals and regular expressions. So objects are key value pairs. So maybe you have an item there, key 1, and then the value. So we are going to look at each and every one of these. So that's an object. Then we have regular expressions. So regular expressions, these are patterns used for pattern matching. Maybe you have a statement that says, my name is X, and you want to match name. You want to make sure maybe name has a capital N. So there's a way you can do that using regular expressions. And maybe you want to return back something, maybe return name. So essentially, you can use regular expressions for patterns. And you're going to see how instrumental they'll be in your career as a programmer. They're very instrumental. And once you learn them, you're going to like them. So that's it for this video. I will see you in the next video when we get started looking at integer literals. See you then.